Hello, this is Autumn Garibay. I do custom hand-painted designs on fencing masks. This one in particular was a treat. It's a bee mask for a HEMA fighter. Specifically, the design is a honeybee on some honeycomb, and it's painted on an Absolute Force HEMA mask. I've done something similar to this design before, so it was a great opportunity to rethink, change, and improve my bee design on this one. I've had a lot of people ask how I paint these masks, so I recorded me painting this one. A common question is if I sketch out the design beforehand, and no, I can't sketch onto the mask per se, but I sketch out my ideas and designs in pencil on paper first, then I lightly paint it onto the mask with a technique called dry brushing. It's just using a little bit of undiluted paint on your brush and painting lightly so it can still be removed if you don't like it. Once I'm happy with the placement, I paint more confidently the design in white paint. I still paint somewhat lightly and with a small brush so the mesh is still see-through when it's worn. I don't want to be filling in any of those holes or making the mesh any thicker. The design is for the people you're facing. You shouldn't be able to tell the mask is painted from the inside of it. Otherwise, it would obscure the view. So this design is a bee with its wings down on top of some honeycomb. The honeycomb was a bit hard because hexagons don't fit perfectly on a curved surface. They actually meet with a pentagon in the middle, like a soccer ball, but instead of doing that, I just varied the sizes of the hexagons to give it some perspective and also make it look a little more like a real honeycomb. Once I complete the design in white paint, I paint over it with color. I keep the color paint runnier than I did the white, and the color will stand out on the white, but not the black parts of the mask. Also, I don't want to make these two layers too thick because there are two or three of them. I used three colors on this mask: white, yellow ochre, and brown. Four if you count the black of the mask. I used white under the design, but also over it for the wings. The yellow ochre is on most parts of the mask for both the bee and the honeycomb. And then I did the legs, parts of the wings, and the antenna in brown, also mixing it with some of the ochre for parts of the body of the bee. I then do a thin spray of clear coat to keep it on longer, and after it dries, it's ready for combat. This mask definitely has an intimidation factor on anyone who's scared or allergic to bees. Anyway, I love this mask and how the design came out. If you would like your mask painted like this, I am taking commissions. You can find me on Facebook at Like the Season Art. I believe masks should have as much personality as the fighter behind them, and this bee mask definitely does. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.